Hello, welcome to my talk, all about the fluids. This talk is the third part of the talk on the topic of the boundary element method for wave structure interaction. This talk focuses on how the hydrostatic and the hydrodynamic forces and the moment can be calculated once the relevant potential functions have been served, which would include the hydrostatic forces, wave exciting forces, as well as the radiation forces in terms of added mass and the radiation damping coefficient. The fluid pressure, or more specifically the gauge pressure in fluid, can be obtained from the Bernoulli's equation expressed as this. Here, the capital phi is the time-dependent total velocity potential. For many applications in wave structure interactions, the high-order term in the pressure is generally omitted as a result of linearization to the problem. And this has been employed in the analysis for the first order forces and motions, as we have this. In frequency domain, the pressure is expressed as this. Here, the potential phi is the complex amplitude of the potential function. Substitute the diffraction and the radiation potentials into the linearized pressure. We have the equation as this. Here, we can see the radiation potential is the sum of the radiation potentials of unit amplitude, 6 degrees of freedom motion, surge, sway, heave at the translational motion, and the lower pitch and the yaw at the rotational motion, as seen in this figure. The forces and the moments acting on the marine structure are calculated as the integrals of the fluid pressure on the body surface SB. Here, normal vector n can be seen in here, while the vector r is the vector from the origin of the coordinates to the body surface. For convenience, we can define the new vector component. The conventional vector components m1, n2, and n3 for the translational motion, and the vector component m4, m5, and n6 for the rotational motion. These vector components are same as that we have used for defining the body boundary condition for the radiation potentials. As such, the forces and the moments can be expressed in a uniform format as this. Here, the subscript I equals to 1 to 6, corresponding to the 6 degrees freedom motion, surge, sway, heave, roll, pitch, and yaw. So substitute the fluid pressure into the integral for the force component. We have the force Fi as this. And for the separate the total force, we have the expression for the hydrodynamic and the hydrostatic forces as this. This time is the wave excitation. And this represents the radiation force. And this is the hydrostatic force. For formulating the hydrodynamic and the hydrostatic forces for the structure motion, here we defined the parameters for the hydrostatics. The volume displaced by the structure can be calculated in three directions, on x-axis, on y-axis, and on z-axis, respectively. And all three volumes should be same if the calculation is accurate enough. This information can be very useful in wave structure interaction analysis, where we need to check whether all generated panels are orientated correctly. If all panels are orientated correctly, these three volumes should be very close if they are not identical. And the coordinates of the buoyancy center, XB, YB, and ZB, are given by this formula. The coordinates of the buoyancy center are needed when we calculate the hydrostatic restoring coefficient for the structure. The hydrostatic forces can be calculated as this for all six components for the 6 degrees freedom motion. And in principle, these hydrostatic forces are the so-called zero-order forces. These zero-order forces would be the largest for wave structure interaction, but they would be balanced out with the structure mass in its equilibrium. However, in the analysis of wave structure interaction, due to the motion of the structure, there will be the net hydrostatic forces given as this, the equation 1 here, which can be regarded as the restoring forces. And these hydrostatic forces can be regarded as the first order hydrostatic forces with the non-zero Cij given as this. Some of this may vanish depending on the symmetry of the structure. For the radiation force, if we exchange the order of the integral and the summation, we have this. Substitute the radiation body boundary condition into the equation, and then we have this expression. Now we can define the coefficient Fij by this. This coefficient can be understood as the complex force in the direction I due to the motion of unit amplitude in the direction J. As such, we have the expression as this for the total radiation force. Now, if we enclose the fluid domain using the body surface SB, the large control surface SC, the free surface SF, then the seabed SZ, we can formulate an equation as this using the Green's theorem for the radiation potentials phi I and phi j. And for the radiation potentials, we have shown the integral on the control surface, a very large control surface SC, and the integrals on free surface SF and the seabed SZ would be all zero. For the details of this, please see my talks on the boundary element method for wave structure interaction, part 1 and part 2. So as such, we can have the integral equation for the radiation potentials on body surface SB only. And this equation shows the coefficient Fij is symmetric. means Fij equals to Fji. If the structure moves on the sea or near the free surface, the coefficient Fij would contain both real and imaginary parts expressed as this. And Aij is called as the added mass. And Bij is the radiation damping due to the wave radiation. So, we can write the total radiation force as this, the equation 2. The wave exciting forces are the forces due to the incoming wave and the scattered wave on the structure. The incoming wave could cause the fluid clear off force on a fixed structure. So the wave excitation can be expressed as this. This is the direct integral for the wave excitation. If the scattering potential phi s and the radiation potential phi I are both served, and here the incoming wave potential phi zero is a known function if the wave amplitude and the wave frequency and the water depths are given. Based on the Green's theorem, again, we can construct an equation for the scattering and the radiation potentials on an enclosed boundary SB plus SC plus SF plus SZ as this. For a similar reason, the integral for the scattering and radiation potentials on the very large control surface SC and on the free surface SF and on the seabed SZ would be all zero. Hence, we have equation as this, and put this together, we have the integral on SB only for the scattering and the radiation potentials as this. Therefore, the wave excitation now can be expressed after using the relation. We have the expression as this. Now, we apply the body boundary condition for the scattering potential. So we have the expression for the wave excitation as this, the equation 3. This equation is called the Haskind relation. Use the Haskind relation means we can use the radiation potential to calculate the exciting forces, even if the scattering potential is not served. Once the forces and the moments are calculated, we can establish the dynamic equation for the structure motion based on the Newton's second law of motion as this, for the translational motion and for the rotational motion. If we put this in the component form, we can write the dynamic equation as this. Here, Fi is the total hydrostatic and hydrodynamic forces expressed as the sum of hydrostatic force, radiation force, and exciting force as this. And Mij is called mass matrix given as this. Here M is the mass of the structure, and Ij is calculated as this, and the coordinates xg, yg, and zg are the coordinates of the center of gravity.